Hello, beautiful people! Welcome to episode 1 of To All the Projects I've Done Before. Today we're going to talk about my first ever group project that I did with 5 other lovely humans at Brown in the year 2018. It was for our class Introduction to Public Humanities, taught by Professor Steve Lubar. Today's title is, Should We Put Up This Statue? And the statue in question is of the author Howard Phillips Lovecraft, commonly known as H.P. Lovecraft. Though personally, I've never been a fan of H.P. Lovecraft and didn't really know much about his work until I read The Call of Cthulhu for this project, what I did know is that his work left an influence on so many things today, especially the genre of horror fiction. His writing also inspired works like Pirates of the Caribbean, Stranger Things, and video games like World of Warcraft, and creatives like Stephen King and Guillermo del Toro have found inspiration in the spooky world of Lovecraft. So, who is H.P. Lovecraft? Born in Providence, Rhode Island in 1890, passed away in 1937, H.P. Lovecraft showed talent in the written word at a young age and later on created many horror stories. Think of Lovecraft as one of the celebrities that people usually associate Rhode Island with. I remember this guy that I met during orientation. He said that one of the reasons he chose Brown was because of Lovecraft. Although the celebrity my mom thought of when it comes to Rhode Island was this one.
Describe your perfect date.
It's a tough one. I'd have to say April 25th because it's not too hot, not too cold. All you need is a light jacket.
Despite Lovecraft's posthumous fame, there is a dark side to the author. His letters and works reveal racist, anti-Semitic, xenophobic views, and many more, which of course spark controversy. So there was this life-size bronze statue of Lovecraft commissioned by the Lovecraft Arts and Science Council here in Providence, and they seek to put this statue in the city. You might have already guessed from the introduction that, well, okay, putting such a statue out there could cause distress and even protest. So should we put the statue up? And if so, what are some do's and don'ts to consider? Most importantly, how could we approach commemorating someone with nuance and sensitivity? This was where us public humans came in. We were assigned to create this briefing book for the Providence Department of Art, Culture, and Tourism to further the consideration of the statue. Our result was this 14-page briefing book that outlines Lovecraft's extreme racist views, potential controversies that a statue may cause, and ways that related issues may be addressed. Basically, we contextualized Lovecraft's legacy with relevance to the current climate in our society. Let's take a closer look at the statue. So, we have the author's depiction and some elements of his work, like these two cats, which we'll further discuss later. Yes, we're gonna talk about cats in this video. And two other explanatory plaques were also planned to go along with the statue. As of the time we did this project, there were already 8 other Lovecraft commemorations in the city of Providence, and his resting place is the nearby Swan Point Cemetery, which is still, till today, a popular spot for visitors in Providence, so are other places he frequented. Then, what would this new statue, should he be put up, bring to the table? As a former English major, I'm quite familiar with looking into a writer's past and contextualize their legacy, and it's usually a pretty fun process. At the John Hay Library at Brown sits a collection of Lovecraft's letters that her group could access. As a proud nerdy human, I was so excited to just look at some old writings and old books. We also met up with the director of the Lovecraft's Arts and Science Council at this restaurant/bar where we talk about all things Lovecraft with insight from this scholar who's partial to Lovecraft's work. With our research, supervision from a professor, and exchanges of ideas from a cohort, our briefing book was coming along. While Lovecraft was a talented writer who created these dark and mythical universes that still capture people today, he held extreme racist, xenophobic, white supremacist views and expressed hatred against immigrants. Now, why does that sound familiar? It should be noted that Lovecraft's views were quite extreme even for his lifetime, let alone our time now. A quick Google search will lead you to all the controversial things Lovecraft had said, or you can check out this game, Lovecraft or Hitler, where a bunch of quotes are put together and you get to guess whether it's from Lovecraft or from Hitler. Oh, will you be surprised? Now let's come back to the statue. So we have here is a life-size bronze form of Lovecraft. From what we discussed, would likely spark controversy in addition to spooking people out when they see a human figure in the bushes in the middle of the night. And the cats. What about the cats? In one of Lovecraft's short stories, The Rats in the Walls, the cat featured in a story was named with a racial slur. And during his lifetime, Lovecraft himself also kept a cat by that name. Just picture yourself touring the city of Providence and then you were greeted by such imagery. With all that said, you might think that, okay, this is bad, clearly bad, but do we have to overthink this much? Well, when it comes to people or ideals we uphold, I think it is always better to think deeper and be aware of what ideals we are advocating for, intentionally or unintentionally. Statues and monuments, especially those in the public area, were often heavily discussed wherever you are in the world. And who we chose to memorialize or celebrate often reflect what kind of ideals we welcome in the society. Therefore, it is very important. Our group finalized our briefing book with the following recommendations should the statue be put out. We made a design suggestion, so either to remove the cats and or place a large plaque in the shape of the outline of the statue at the base so that it reads as the statue's shadow, which would explain and contextualize Lovecraft's beliefs and also symbolizing the dark side of the author. Furthermore, the location where the statue is holds significant meaning. Putting it out there in public where anyone, everyone of all ages and background could see versus putting it in a private space would be quite different. Also, our group highly recommend consultation on this project. This could be done with historians, local communities, cultural groups, and with relevant resources such as the Center for the Study of Race and Ethnicity in America and the Center for the Study of Slavery and Justice at Brown University. Of course, we also suggest having public input, making information available to the public, and producing programming centered around race, history, and social context. Also, considering parallel examples of other controversial figures, other authors of a similar past. For example, Edgar Allan Poe. The programming of Edgar Allan Poe provides a good model for contextualizing an author and their legacy. Reflections! Even though I don't particularly enjoy Lovecraft's work and his horrific views on race, gender, and the humanity in general really throw me off, this doesn't erase the fact that, hey, he's made a mark as a writer. When we think about the legacy of someone or something, should we leave out the bad things and sugarcoat the good things? Also, what opportunities would be lost if we completely refrain from talking about certain people, certain works, or certain events? I believe that there are definitely ways to contextualize and approach a person's legacy that encourage nuanced interpretation and respectful discussions. For the case of Lovecraft, while many people celebrate his work, I think we should not ignore the explicit and implicit racism in his work. I think having an inclusive and maybe creative approach to his legacy could open doors to nuanced interpretations. Though I haven't watched it myself, it seems that the 2020 adapted TV series Lovecraft Country is a good example of such. I think this whole thing brings out a million-dollar question. Could we separate an artist from their artwork? Like, yes, someone could be an exceptional talent in their field, while that someone could also hold many controversial views, or vice versa. All of us are multidimensional human beings, and one thing doesn't necessarily cancel the other. There are just so many layers and nuances, and different communities might have different points of view. And of course, society's values shift and all that. I think all that is to say that it is crucial to approach someone's legacy with a nuanced understanding and diverse perspectives. And these things are actually really close to our everyday lives. You know, just think about artists, writers, athletes, political figures that you admire. Honestly, everyone. Especially, sadly, in this wave of cancel culture, some people are so quick to make judgments, and it just makes all these discussions even more important. I think most of us would agree that some evil are really just too malevolent to even have a space on a public monument, let alone be told in any narration that gives it any benefit of the doubt. While for some instances that have space for discussion, if we're analyzing a person's legacy, may they be living or dead, I think the intention of that person's deeds is very important. We're all humans, we all make mistakes, and if that person's intention is not to harm anyone, there's more likely room for constructive criticism and discussions and understanding. I hope it's obvious that this video is not to shame any Lovecraft fans or anyone that enjoys some things or someone that could be controversial. Everything has its context, and people grow and change, and so does our society. Moreover, I think we oftentimes don't fully know someone's backstory that shape their ideas, opinions, and fears. All right, that was a lot for a first episode. Here is some floof content as a reward for those who stayed till this far.
Kaya, sit. Good girl.
I've heard that the next episode is gonna be something floofy and fun and maybe a little bit weird. Just watch till the end for some hint for the next episode. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you feel like hanging out here more, subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram. I'll see you again in the next episode of To All the Projects I've Done Before, and like the other videos too. Hope you're doing well wherever you are. Stay safe, and I'll see you again soon. Bye! Squeaky chair. Life-size bronze. Now let's come back to the statue. That's the center for the study of race and... is this a good cut? Oh my god.